Initially, when the virus first started to sweep across the world and our country, we had no treatment, and we were trying to figure out what things might work. And we've become much smarter about the things that work for people who have serious infection from COVID. But in the early days, people were trying to figure out, are there drugs that we may have that are already FDA approved that may be effective somehow in helping a person to get through a serious coronavirus COVID-19 infection. And one of the very first of those was a drug called hydroxychloroquine or Plaquenil. It's actually an anti-malarial drug, but it does have some anti-inflammatory properties. We use it, for instance, in people that have mild cases of what's called lupus. And in fact, the Food and Drug Administration, or the FDA, gave provisional approval, what's called an emergency use authorization, to try hydroxychloroquine, and eventually removed that authorization because it didn't help. It wasn't helpful. And then the focus sort of shifted in the population of thinking about maybe drugs like ivermectin. And in the test tube, if you take ivermectin, which is a anti-parasitic agent that's approved for use in animals and in humans to prevent like hookworm infections. If you take the test tube and grow coronavirus, you can add ivermectin and it will inhibit the growth of coronavirus. But the trouble is that the concentrations in the test tube of ivermectin that would be required to inhibit the proliferation of the virus are so high that if you took that much drug into your body, it would be toxic, it could kill you. So yes, ivermectin has had some potential as potentially a treatment, but there's no studies indicating that in doses that would be safe for people, that it's effective either as a agent to prevent and to prophylax against coronavirus infection or to treat coronavirus infection. And you might say, well, why not take it anyway, just in case? The trouble is that now that we've been dealing with COVID-19 for 18 months, we do have effective treatments for people who get infected. If they're sick enough to be in the hospital, we use steroids to decrease that lung inflammation. We use anticoagulants because coagulation of the blood is part of the disease process. But we also have, and people know about this because President Trump, when he got ill with the COVID-19, was one of the few people in the country who got this infusion of so-called monoclonal antibodies. And monoclonal antibodies are antibodies that have been made in the laboratory that will recognize that spike protein and neutralize the virus. And so if you get COVID-19 and you're not sick enough to be in the hospital, and you get treatment with the monoclonal antibodies, which we give at our hospital, you, even if you're not vaccinated yet, or even if you're vaccinated, you can avoid serious illness. And we've seen people who stayed home taking ivermectin, even though they were sick with COVID, and by the time they come to the hospital, they're so sick that they're beyond the point where monoclonal antibodies would be effective. And so at this point, ivermectin and other drugs that have been proposed are not as effective as the therapies that we currently have available, and people are relying on those and foregoing vaccination, which could prevent serious illness, or treatment with monoclonal antibodies, which could prevent development of serious illness even after you get infected. So it's no government plot or anything to avoid the use of ivermectin. It's just that there's no evidence that it's going to be helpful in fighting COVID-19.